The students with the purple skulls represent those students that have achieved highest honors. That's 4.0 and above.
How do you go about?
We will be honoring those students just a little later. At this time, I'd like for you to stand again and Leah Reed, the senior class vice president, will lead us with an invitation.
And keep us safe as we go our separate ways. Amen. And now Cassandra Heimel will lead us in the pledge.
Sums it up just right. We got to roll with the punches. anxious, play all over unconscious, make the best of whatever comes our way. Forget that one, forget the blind ambition, learn to trust your intuition, follow straight ahead, come what may. We are now ready to move on to new challenges and dreams. It is now time that we must take it to a higher level, to go beyond what we think we are capable of achieving. We are the first graduating class of the new millennium, and we must set the standards for the next century by pushing ourselves to a higher level. We must strive to be the best we can be in life. It is now time to step up to the plate and show everyone who we really are. It is time to apply the knowledge that we have gained through all of these life lessons. As most of us have heard before, life is full of uncertainties. It is how we choose to handle these uncertainties that will predict our future. The faculty, administration, coaches, and staff at American High School, as well as our families, have provided us with the foundation to make the best possible choices in our lives. As we come forward tonight to receive our diplomas, each of us is filled with mixed emotions. Besides being proud to be a graduating American High School Redskin, we are also nervous and scared. Nervous and scared because we don't know what the future holds for us. Sad because we have now completed a chapter of our lives. Excited because we know we can do anything, whatever the future has in store for us. This is not an ending, but rather a new beginning. We have a choice in what our lives are to become. We are in control now. We have the knowledge. We have the power. Our promise to all of you is to embrace and conquer all of the freedom and all of the challenges that lie before us. In conclusion, I will leave you with a quote from Alexander Lockhart. Look forward, not backward. Be a leader, not a follower. Focus on your successes and learn from your failures. Stay away from people who belittle your ambitions. Trust your hopes, not your fears. Go the extra mile. Thank you and good luck.
Sixth grade was a big transition for all of us. New friends were made and new freedoms allowed. For the first time, we could walk in the halls without being a single file line. Life was good. Everyone showed up for interviews as competition was at the max. We all looked to fit in. In seventh grade, we were able to represent our school in athletic competition for the first time. People became divided into stereotypical groups, but kids would be kids. Now the top group consisted of the basketball players and cheerleaders. If you were one, you dated the other. It was the only way. We were all glad to give the sixth graders a hard time, and glad to be out of the main sixth grade building. But who would have ever thought that we could have been any bigger and badder than we were in eighth grade? We ruled the school in every aspect. We even got the top four. By now, homeroom struggled to get participants for any girls. It just wasn't as cool as it was in sixth grade. Besides, we were practically in high school. We had to act older. Unfortunately, in eighth grade, tragedy struck our class. In honor of our friend and classmate, Matthew McCall, who would have been graduating with us tonight, I would like to take this opportunity to dedicate all of our songs on his life. Freshman year was not forgettable. Everyone started on the same foot with a clean slate. That first day, we all walked the halls, clueless of where we were and where we were going, hoping someone would give us a hand. At 5'2" and 95 pounds, I was just waiting for my first tour of a trip to a trash can at the hands of the upperclassmen. After all, that's all I learned about in eighth grade. I soon found that high school would be a great place full of freedom and opportunity. We were introduced to block scheduling, and for the most part, we liked it. We were also supposedly told that we would have no valedictorian because of the new county policy. The main problem that the guys had in high school was the fact that we couldn't get a date. The girls, however, didn't share that problem, as the older guys jumped on the chance to date them. Homecoming and battle of the classes instantly became something we would love in the next 3 years. Our first float was quite an adventure, and our first guy cheerleading team was sabotaged by the juniors. Being freshmen, we didn't think to have a backup day, and well, ours got cut. The show still went on, but it was nothing impressive. All in all, ninth grade was a year to test the waters on HHS, and we all were glad to do so. As sophomores, the aura of high school had created the greatest significance about being a sophomore's dead and dead with freshmen. We were no longer afraid to wind up in high school, as most of them became our friends. We earned a little more respect for the teachers as time went by and had more opportunities to get involved in school activities. However, the worst thing about being a sophomore was that it was like a Wednesday. We knew how much these are, right, during the week, and as sophomores, this is how it felt. We had already completed our freshman year, but we still had to go with two more years before we graduate. It was a sign that the new sophomores who became eligible received their driver's license at the magical age of 16. But the excitement quickly vanished when we realized that we had to fire by the test scores and turn from what seemed like an easy climb to school every morning. Overall, our sophomore year was a stepping stone for becoming an upperclassman. The junior year was perhaps the most comfortable year of high school. We had reached upper class status, and most of us were driving. College search began, and April fall, classes were offered that we could take for the first time. Most of us stealthily parked early, trying to avoid Mr. Barber in the mornings so we wouldn't have to break another year walking on the tennis courts. I and many others began realizing how lucky we were to be unaffected by school to work as we watched our younger friends complain about the delays and pauses. Several of us got jobs for the first time. As battle of the classes raged on, we went through the usual junior year where every other class hates you. It's a rite of passage. In our junior year, we were honored to organize and host the prom. Many of us gave time and money, and prom was a total success. As we watched the seniors of the class of 99 receive their diplomas, it finally sunk in for many of us that we were now at the top of the school. We were now seniors. Ah, only we were seniors, the top dogs of our high school. All the underclassmen left us with us today. Life can get any better than this. As seniors, we knew the system, we knew all the teachers, and we knew all what we could and could not get away with. There were certain perks and privileges that came with being a senior. Like being able to get in front of the class every day and just about everything in our honor from prom to senior graduation. However, being a senior wasn't easy. The school activities that we enjoyed over the past 3 years would soon come to an end, and we knew that we would have to say goodbye to our friends and classmates soon. As we all knew, the most agonizing thing about being a senior was filling out endless stacks of college and scholarship applications in one graduate. At the end of school year drew closer, many seniors came down with severe cases of senioritis, where some students were waiting to arrive late to school and might not show up at all. And now, as we look back upon our accomplishments and our efforts, we must not forget the people that helped us reach this point in our lives. We cannot forget the love and support of our family and friends, and we also cannot forget the teachers who have helped us along the way. And believe it or not, the night that we have worked for so hard for the past 13 years has finally arrived. And now, as we begin to close the books in our class history, we would like to issue some challenges to both Reagan High School and the class of 2000 for the future. First, I would like to challenge Reagan High School. Tonight, all of us speakers are not speaking based on merit, but purely upon the selection by the peers and the part of the vote. I challenge Reagan High School that upon tradition and graduation, next year, place academics in the forefront of the ceremony. 4 years ago, the decision was made to eliminate valedictorian, salutatorian, honorary. Only this year did we realize the impact of this decision on our Graduation is the only purely academic function to honor all students who have fulfilled the academic requirements. Four is to know every student is given the same opportunities to excel. And at this time, Sarah Green, Chad Johnson, and Melissa Berry, please come forward to assist Aaron Vickers in challenging the class 2000. At Putnam County, not revised their policy on graduation a few years back. I would have been speaking today as valedictorian of the Berg High Class of 2000. I, and many others, feel that it is important that those who have achieved the most academically be recognized that this, the mother of academic functions, as an important part of the history of the Class of 2000, we would like to honor those who have reached for the highest achievement. Aaron Vickers, valedictorian, Chad Johnson, and Sarah Green, salutatorian, and Melissa Gray, honorary. As I've told many of my friends, if I step up to the mic for anything, I'm giving a speech. Well, here it is. Tonight, Chad, Sarah, Melissa, and I are going to speak on the final thoughts that we would each like to leave with our classmates as we all begin to write the next chapter in our lives. My thoughts comes from my favorite quote, one some of you may have seen on my online member profile. As Abraham Lincoln said, things may come to those who wait, but only the things left behind by those who hustle. I believe that all of us here today capable of success in life. However, from this day forward, we can't expect our parents and teachers to corral us towards our goals. Starting tonight, we are all on a level playing field. 10 years from now, no one will care who got the big scholarship or who spoke at graduation, because it won't matter. What will matter is what we each do with the opportunities we are given. I challenge each of you to work your hardest in the coming years, because effort is all that will separate those who succeed with those who fail. I challenge everyone to out-hustle the rest and make your dreams come true. Now, I'm pleased to introduce to you the would/should-be co-salutatorian, Sarah Green, who has something for us.
If a man is called to be a street sweeper, he should sweep streets, even as Michelangelo paintings, or Beethoven who has music, or Shakespeare for a poetry. He should sweep streets so well that all the hosts of heaven and earth will pause to say, here lived the great street sweeper who did his job well. It is my hope that every member of the class of 2000 excels in what they choose to do, whatever it may be. And now,
would be Castellatorian Chad Johnson as a speaker. So now that high school is over, what are we going to do? Well, some of us are entering the workforce, some of us are heading off to various branches of the military, and many of us are planning to attend college or university and pursue further education. Whatever our actions actually may be, I'd like to encourage everyone to strive for excellence in the lives to come. Theodore Roosevelt once said, it's hard to fail, but worse never to have tried to succeed. We should all remember this great advice, because life inevitably brings us many challenges. Failure is almost certain. However, the success we achieve may not be measured in financial gain or by climbing a corporate ladder. Success lies merely in the fact that we try and we gave it our all. This is my challenge to the graduating class of 2000. Approach life with confidence, knowing that no matter what happens, that you try and you can walk away knowing that you did your best. Now I'd like to encourage the would-be honorary Melissa Gray.
Stand.
challenge American High School to keep academics at the forefront of graduation and open the future to keep this tradition alive. Thank you, and God bless the class of God.
Thank you.
Without the one that had the senior video, we would caution you on the movement, the auditorium.